hot summer's day, a lonely lake, Northern Pike.
And that's who we've got tonight on cue, the Northern Pikes.
Northern Pikes. Well, that's sort of, we sort of stumbled upon that by accident. We were out in a lounge one evening trying to think of a name for the band that was a little bit different, but still something that people could identify with. Northern Pikes came up and we sort of made jokes about it, about sturgeons and stuff for about a half hour. And then the next day, Jay phoned me up and said, what do you think about Northern Pikes? And I said, well, I don't know, it seems okay. We'll go with it for now. And it sort of stuck. So that's sort of the story behind that. But I don't know, I kind of like it. Yeah. How about you? Yeah, you like it? Good.
On Cue with the Northern Pikes returns in a moment.
I started playing drums about 5 years ago. I took lessons for 3 years from Hans Van Noren, who's my teacher. He's a jazz drummer. And then I started playing in bands on weekends and stuff for a couple of years, and then I ended up here with the Northern Pikes. And you get energy from the crowd. You know, you're getting energy from the crowd when you're playing live, and it's fun to see, you know, people dancing to original songs and stuff like that. It makes you want to, you know, makes you play harder. And that's where you learn, you know, that's where you learn how to play, is on the road. And when you come into the studio, it's good too, but you have to be a little more conservative. I really can't, you know, I can't tell you much about it except that Jay wrote it. And I know it's about one of his old girlfriends. Why can't you look me in the eye?
When I say I'm here. Why can't you look me in the eye?
Why can't you look me in the eye, baby? Is when I say love, it's love.
You've got a hold on me, you see. I just can't escape. That's my reaction. Why can't you look me in the eye? When I say it's love, it's what I'm thinking of. I'll bet you got above. Right now, why can't you look me in the eye? When I say goodbye to you, always tied to you. If I cry to you, okay. You've got a hold on me, you see. I just can't. Why can't you look me in the eye? Why can't you look me in the eye? Why can't you look me in the eye?
Because I've played in a lot of bands, and mostly just top 40 bands. And you just play whatever rhythm the song has. And this band is more just sort of a driving dance rhythm. That's what we're trying to do, or so much on the first album anyways. If you play what other people want to hear, you know, you don't get the enjoyment out of it because you're not playing your own stuff. When they hear it and they like, you're playing your own material and they like it, it's quite enjoyable then because it makes it all worthwhile. It's the whole thing, you know, getting your feelings across in the music instead of someone else's. Sometimes you get sort of bored in between playing and traveling. That can be the boring part of it. But I do enjoy it because you get to meet quite a few interesting people. And it's quite rewarding, you know, when things happen, things are starting, you know, you're playing in a good club and the people see you and they really enjoy you and they've never heard of you before. You know, you're just sort of going out in new frontiers, whatever you'd call it.
With the Northern Pikes returns in a moment.
I discovered I didn't want to work a real job, so I thought I'd learn guitar quick and try to do that instead. It's out of sheer laziness, basically. About our bus, well, I'd like to drive it into the river myself, but, and I think 4 out of 5 of us agree, but right now, it's the cheapest form of transportation. It gets us around pretty reliably. Sometimes it tends to surprise us, but most of the time it's pretty reliable, and it's cheap. And you can sleep in it when you want to. I Think I'm Sorry is simply, I think, someone who's sorry that their relationship is over with. It's an observation, and that's all.
Night song. sleep will come the way it does, the way it does. Sleep will come the way it does. Sleep will come. And I think that I'm sorry.
It's all learning. It's just like going into the recording studio. When you're in there, you're learning, and you're in front of a camera, you're learning how to, you know, how not to be nervous and be relaxed and be yourself and just go with it and work with it instead of trying to fight it and stay away, you know. Concerts are great too, because you look out and you see all these people, and it's, I don't know, it sort of sets you back a little bit, but it's a lot of fun. Dancing in the Dance Club. Great song. Basically, it's just sort of tired of the routine of going out for, you know, a cup of joe or to a movie or for pie or whatever, and going to a dance club and just sort of letting yourself go and enjoying yourself.
on Cue with the Northern Pikes returns in a moment.
I don't know how you'd classify the music exactly. I'd say it's maybe a cross between a whole bunch of things. I have a lot of different influences that I have in my writing. I think I try and write about sort of things that have happened to me. It's basically personal observations and stuff like that. We have certain goals. We're trying to, I think our first goal is to get signed to a recording contract, you know, so that we can do our own music exclusively and also get more people to notice it, you know, more people to listen to it, and that's really how you get going. I don't think your career as a, you know, as an artist really starts happening until you get the recording contract, and that's what we're really after. I've been writing a lot of new songs and have a lot of new material that the band's working on right now, and we're hoping to record again sometime in the early part of next year, either January or February, and hopefully put out a full album. And I think after we do that, I think there's a good chance we may get signed after that, just for the fact that we will have improved, we'll have been around for a while and given ourselves more credibility. Public to Notice was sort of a rhythmic dance song. I think that was, the words came out of being sort of frustrated about really not getting the recognition, you know, that I thought that the band has deserved in the past, or some of the bands that I've been with have deserved in the past, just from the amount of work we've put into it, you know, and the fact that there is a lot of stuff that's really not very good in the music market today, or I don't think it's very good anyway, and I think our product is as good or better, and I think we're trying to get the public to notice, you know, the public to have a look at it and see what, let them judge for themselves, give it a chance, you know.
Public to notice. She'll get the public to notice.